I know we can't change the past, Janet. But I'm happy to see you having this new baby the right way with your husband by your side.
Pop, there's something.
Hold on, Janet. This has been a long time coming. I know I haven't been the perfect father, but maybe it's not too late. I want to be a real grandfather to your kids. I want to be a part of your life, part of the family, if you'll have me. I'm so proud of you.
Mr. Kent, you don't understand. My fiance already saw this home and she loves it. She's been through so much. Her daughter has leukemia. She deserves this home, and I'm not leaving here until she gets it.
Over my dead body.
Well, that could be the ring.
Let him go, Dusty.
Oh, get out of here.
I said Jack. Let him go!
You're gonna mess up everything for me
no,
again?
No, because you're doing a pretty good job of that yourself. Don't make things worse than they already are.
You're not getting my house.
Sir, why don't you go? I can handle things from here.
You gonna arrest me? So I threatened the guy, so what? He's a jerk.
Funny. I bet he thinks the same thing about you.
I'm trying to make Janet comfortable, trying to make her happy. I offer this guy a blank check. Who walks away from that kind of cash?
Somebody who obviously loves that.
Or somebody who's a jerk.
It's not a crime in Illinois. Assault is.
Assault? Me? Okay. All right. Take me and enjoy yourself.
Put your hands down, Dustin. You're right. It's a beautiful home. I can definitely see Janet living here.
Yeah?
How many bedrooms?
4 for when Johnny visits. Janet's got her heart really set on this place.
Sounds like she's not the only one.
Yeah, there's something about it I really like. Kane's not gonna sell it to me, especially now.
It could be another way.
Go on.
You didn't hear it from me, but I know this guy, Kane. He's under investigation for securities fraud. It's a good case, too. I bet if you tip off the seller, they'll put the house back on the market.
You sure about this?
Case goes before the grand jury at the end of the month. If this comes back on me, I'll deny it.
No, it won't. You have my word. Hey, Jack. Thanks.
Why didn't Jack come with you?
Oh, Jack's working.
You know, when I found out you married a cop, I was concerned. You know what I'm talking about.
Actually, no, because we don't know each other that well, remember?
That's why I'm here, Janet, to get to know you and your husband. Teresa tells me he's a good man, good father.
He is.
How many kids does he have already?
It's complicated. All right, he's got three kids. And he's a great father to all of them. And he's gonna be a wonderful father to this baby.
That's all I want for you, sweetheart, is someone who loves you and your child. A man who's going to take care of you.
I have that. Hello?
I've been ringing Carly's doorbell for 10 minutes. Where are you?
I'm in Minnesota with Liberty.
Is she okay?
Well, she's okay, thank God. But she just... I talked to her on the phone earlier, and she sounded so scared and all alone. So I just hopped on the next plane to Minnesota, and I'm here with her now.
By yourself?
No, I'm with Carly. You don't have to worry.
Let me talk to him for a minute.
No, Pop, you don't...
Jack, it's Rocco, your father-in-law. I just wanted to say that...
Mr. Ciccone, this isn't Jack. This is Dusty Donovan.
Donovan? What are you...
Tell Janet I'll be there as soon as I can.
Your friend Dusty says he's coming to visit.
He's a great guy. Very, very nice. When Liberty first got sick, the treatments weren't working, so he's the one that called around and found this hospital for her. He's a good friend.
Sounds like it.
Okay. Pop, I'm gonna going to go. But I'll talk to you soon, all right?
My mom's always going to be in Uncle Jack's life now. It's not going to be easy for you to deal with.
I'll handle it.
I know you want to, but if I'm gone, she's going to need extra help from Jack. And you know how he is when someone needs him.
You listen to me. You are not going to die. You have a lot of people who love you and are praying for you. It's just not your time. I know it.
Hey. What's going on in here?
Nothing. We're just talking.
Okay, well, I appreciate you coming, Carly. Dusty's on his way, so you can head back if you want to.
I'll see you soon. Count on it.
Sorry if I scared you.
Oh, that's okay, baby. Gosh, I miss you so much. I just want to crawl in there and hug you and squeeze you until you beg me to stop.
Oh, trust me, Mom. The plastic bubble is not all it's cracked up to be. But they're doing a whole bunch of tests this week, and then we'll know if the treatment worked and when I can get back to the world. Or not.
I'm thinking positive.
Me too, Mom.
Mrs. Ciccone, nice to see you again.
Why are you here?
I'm here to be with my fiance.
The little blonde Carly?
No, not Carly. Janet.
My daughter's a married woman. She's having a baby, for God's sakes.
She's getting a divorce. Jack's filing papers right now. As soon as it's official, Janet and I are getting married.
I knew it was too good to be true.
What's that?
Janet. She didn't learn a thing. She ruined one child's life, now she's doing it again. That baby she's carrying is an innocent soul. He deserves to grow up with a mother and a father.
I'm gonna be with him.
You're not a father. You're an adulterer.
You think it's better she hangs out with a guy she doesn't love?
No wonder she lied to me. She's ashamed of herself.
Glad you're here.
Mm. Feeling okay?
Oh, I feel fine. I'm much better now that you're here. You're not mad at me that I took off without telling you, are you?
No, how can I be mad at you? You're here for your daughter. Where have you been? I've been trying to reach on your cell all day. I go straight to voicemail.
Long story.
Where's Janet?
She is in Minnesota with Liberty.
You let her take off to Minnesota?
She was worried about her daughter. She wasn't gonna let me stop her.
Did you try?
Yes, I tried. And when that didn't work, I went with her. And then I waited for Dusty to show up, and then I came back home. Great day. So sorry it's over. You're welcome.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm sorry.
Good.
How are you? You all right?
Not really. I talked to Liberty. She's convinced she's dying. She wanted me to promise to hold everything together when that happens. Make sure Janet is taken care of.
What, does that mean that the treatments aren't working?
I think she's just scared.
Things are gonna be okay. We'll see. And in the meantime, I'm doing what she wants. I filed for divorce, and Dusty's getting that house she wanted.
Do you really think things are gonna work out?
Yeah. I do. There's a wall between the vanities, but I-